It's great to see all of you. Welcome to the training workshop. This time next week, you'll be dealing with real customers. Working at the airport information desk is a great job, but it can be a tough job. You need to know all about the airport, the airlines, and the facilities. You also need to be sensitive, and you need to be resilient, because people who are traveling are often very tired and can be difficult. So let's go through a few what-if situations and find out what you'd do. Okay, customer number one walks up to the desk and says that he missed his flight, and there isn't another flight until tomorrow night. What would you do? Sammy?
I'd offer to call the airport hotel and make a reservation for him. I'd also check whether he had a frequent flyer number or was entitled to any special deals or discounts.
Fine. Luckily, customer number one is reasonable. I'm afraid we can't say that about customer number two. Customer number two has missed his connecting flight. He gets agitated and blames the airport. He says he never would have missed the flight if the airport weren't so big and confusing. What would you do in that case, Andrea?
Well, I'd explain that there is an interactive map on the website so people can plan everything before they arrive at the airport. I'd say that we advise people to allow plenty of time between connecting flights. I'd tell him that if he'd left a little more time, he wouldn't have missed his flight. And I'd probably say that the information desk attendants are ready and willing to help passengers find their way, and tell him he should have asked them for directions.
That might not work. You might need to show a little more compassion. We'll try this one again in a role play. Before we do that, though, we've got customer number three. Customer number three comes up to the desk. She is angry because her flight has been delayed by bad weather. She's sure that by the time she gets to the meeting she is on her way to, they'll have been discussing the issues for an hour and all the key decisions will have been made. What are you going to do about it, Ricardo?
I'd explain to her that it's a shame that her flight is delayed, but that really the weather is nobody's fault.
That is true, but it usually isn't a very popular response. In fact, it usually infuriates people. Does anyone else have an idea? Anna?
Well, I'd probably say I know what she means. It's so frustrating. Depending on which airline she's flying with, I try to get her into one of the business lounges. That's if she hadn't already been directed there by the airline. She could get a bite to eat and something to drink, use the Wi-Fi, or just relax for a while in peace and quiet. That should improve her mood.
Nice one. Okay, let's try some of these role plays.
Training. Part B. Listen again. Are these statements true or false? Choose the correct answer.